Growing up in a small town, it is very easy to get caught up in tradition. For myself, I've always loved doing the same things around the holidays, hanging out with my hometown people, and staying true to myself. My name is Jackie Potter. I grew up in Haymarket, Virginia, and if you can't tell by the name, we are a very small town. We sit about 55 minutes outside of DC, and not too many people know where we are or what we are about, and I kind of love it that way. So I'm one of four children. My mom and my dad bought our house in Haymarket back in 85, and we've had the same house ever since. My dad had such a vision for what he wanted Haymarket to be like. Our little section of Haymarket is called Evergreen. Our whole neighborhood was so close. But now come to think of it, I think it was because of Evergreen Country Club. Evergreen Country Club was a mutual social gathering spot for all the families to have fun and eat dinner any day of the week.
Asked, you know, how did Haymarket all come together and what did you guys do? And Michelle and I have done a lot and I'm happy to share it. So we had the first 6 acres in 1985. And I'd be running on Saturday mornings and just, again, just absolutely loving the rural nature of what we were all involved in. And then, so lo and behold, I come down to the corner in, you know, a mile from here at the end of the road, and I come across this sign, property for sale. Well, I'm just absolutely frozen frigid that somebody's gonna be building houses, you know, right next to us. It's 11.8 acres for sale. It says, call John Duncan. This little sign was no more than like, you know, 3x5 poster card. So I jogged, I couldn't remember the number, called John up, and it wasn't more than a week or two that we put a deal together, and so by 1988, the 6 acres we had in Haymarket, we added 11.8. Kids today enjoy that. We cut wood on it, we bow hunt, and have preserved it as a nature preserve for turkey and fox and raccoons. It's been terrific.
So as you can see, it is very important to my dad that we preserve our land and make our memories in Haymarket last forever. During the summer, all of our kids in the neighborhood swam for the barracudas. My dad would make my three brothers and I wake up every morning before practice at 7 so we could do our 15 sprints, 50 push-ups, and 50 sit-ups. We would head off to practice right after we finished doing our chores. Luckily, since Evergreen was right up the street, I was able to hang out with all of my friends throughout the day and just walk home after playing with them. All I can say is that Evergreen Country Club was a huge part of my upbringing. By the time I was 15, I needed a job, so I applied for a coaching position for the Barracudas. I was so excited to teach the little kiddos how to swim. Once I graduated high school, I wasn't allowed to swim anymore, so the decision to stay at Evergreen or to find another job was a big decision. But I thought to myself, why would I not stay? I love this job. I love the atmosphere, and this is my home. So I decided to stay. As a swimmer, I always felt so loved and supported by all of my coaches. They were always there to pick me up, motivate me, and show me new ways to improve myself. My mission as a coach was to give all of my swimmers the same amount of attention that I received when I was growing up as a Barracuda. Although one thing I am going to say about Evergreen is that we were kind of a joke. We had a 0-4 season for the past 3 years. This past summer, I was 20 years old, and I finally worked my way up to becoming the head coach of the swim team. I was so honored because I wanted the kids that I coached to have the same experience I had growing up. Going into this job, I already knew that all the parents respected me and they were on my side for success. Although it is tough to gain and hold such a high authority position as a 20-year-old. After a first couple practices, I looked at the team that we had and I looked at my assistant coach and I said, you know what? I want to do this. Let's win. Let's win the whole thing. I want to win district champions. So this was a long stretch, but we were determined. We did not want another 0-4 season. To achieve this goal, Elaine and I, my assistant coach, sat down and brainstormed about how we could improve our team. We knew that we had the fun and positive attitude down pat, but what was left to figure out was how could we win. We knew that many of the swimmers in the past had started to take swimming more seriously by picking up year-round swim. So what was the motivation for these kids? We had half of the team who loved swimming and were really dedicated their heart to this team, but we also had another side of the team that were just about fun. So what we did is we created a buddy system, kind of like big brother, big sister type thing. This helped the little kids get more fired up by looking up to the older swimmers. I made it a point for the older kids to become role models and support their little. I knew it wouldn't be enough because our skill wasn't always there. So we needed a little extra help and something to look forward to. So what we decided to do was to start up clinics after practice, write down goals of all the swimmers in the beginning of each week for them to achieve, and keep the motivation up all the time. Their goals included beating their personal bests, learning a new stroke that they haven't conquered yet, or not disqualifying on a simple mistake. Throughout the season, we stayed with our plan and worked with the swimmers one-on-one every chance we got. Learning what worked and what didn't work throughout the week helped us for the meets on Saturdays. Fast forward a couple weeks, and our hard work was paying off. After winning 3 meets in a row, our streak was alive, and we felt like we could have a chance. Our last meet was against the reigning district champs for the past 5 years. Was I scared? Oh yeah, for sure. But I wanted it really bad. Saturday morning comes around, and it was our last meet. I checked my phone, and I have 3 emails saying that there are kids who are sick, and they will not be able to make it. Unfortunately, those 3 kids were super crucial for our points in winning. We get to the meet, move some people around, hype people up, but the other coach and I ran the numbers for the meet and it didn't look like it was on our side. We kept our moods high and hopeful anyways. My dad was a huge preacher of keeping your mind up, staying in the winner's circle, and always do extra. When I was talking to the kids before the meet started, I told them, no matter who is next to you, you have to do better than yourself, not the person next to you. That doesn't matter. Their hopes were high, and so were mine. One thing I've learned throughout life is that positivity is such a large part of becoming successful. Stay positive, and you will succeed. Coming down to the last points and the relays, our kids were out swimming them, not by talent, but by heart. The end score comes around, and we were crossing our fingers throughout the whole time. The ending score was 242-240. We were the district champions, and we had conquered what we thought was impossible.
Hey, sorry!
Here's the trophy. Okay? Make sure you guys win.
Haymarket has helped me learn so many life lessons. Winning district champions was not only an accomplishment for me as an individual, but also as a swim team as a whole. The Barracudas had overcome so much this past season, and I am so blessed to call them my family.